Hi, it's Paul Anderson, and this is Life Science Core Idea 1B. It's on growth and development of organisms. By the time students graduate high school, they should have an understanding of growth and development. In other words, how we go not only from a kitten to a cat, but how do we go from a cat zygote to a cat? And so the progression at which we teach this at the elementary level, at the lower elementary level, we should talk about growth and change. In other words, we go from an acorn to an oak tree, but an oak tree doesn't just look like a giant acorn. It has somehow changed throughout that time. Or how we go from an egg to a chicken. It's not just a giant egg, but it's changed over time. And so this idea of getting bigger or growth and then also changing. And so how do we go from a baby to mom to grandma to great grandma? That's through growing and changing over our lifetime. And parents are important in that. So we should teach the importance of parenting on making sure that organisms survive that whole way. So in humans, parental care is incredibly important, but also important in birds as they both care for the organism, or even in spiders. This mother is taking care of her little spiderlings. And so we should emphasize the importance of parenting. As we move higher through elementary, we should bring this idea of a life cycle forward. And so in plants, we go from an acorn to a germinated seed, to a sapling, to a tree, and then that tree again is going to produce more acorns, and so this life cycle can continue. In animals, we go from an egg to a hatched egg, to a chick, and then to an adult chicken, and then they lay eggs, and this process continues over and over again. And so now we should bring out these ideas of growth and development. And so if you grow, it means that you get bigger over time. But if you develop, that means that you're becoming different over time, or you're changing. And so there are a lot of steps that are going on from the egg to the chicken that are making it look different than it did when it was just an egg. And so plants and animals have evolved great ability to grow at the correct rate for their environment. And so plants grow really, really slow, but they can grow really, really big, and they continue to grow their whole life. Each of the animals in this community here have evolved to grow at different rates, and that's played against their environment or their success in their environment. But the way they reproduce at the end of that growth can either be asexual or sexual, and we should talk about this in middle school, that are a number of organisms just reproduce by budding off of themselves. And so these hydra, or these freshwater hydra, will just make a copy of themselves, and that forms a new hydra. Or these yeast, the way yeast grows, they simply make a copy of themselves that buds off and that forms a brand new organism. There are advantages to that. It's really, really easy, but there are disadvantages because they're going to look exactly like the parent. And so a lot of organisms, especially when we move to the higher level plants and animals, reproduce sexually. And so the function of flowers is simply to transfer pollen from one plant to another, or to transfer sperm from one plant to another. And so asexual reproduction has some disadvantages, and so these dragonflies are reproducing sexually, and that gives us variation. And so you should emphasize in middle school the importance of plant reproduction, not get so much into animal reproduction. The bee is playing a role here. It's getting honey from the flower, but what it's really doing is it's transferring pollen from one flower to another. And what's inside the pollen? There's simply sperm inside there. And so we're getting variation, and we're going to create seeds that have variation compared to that adult plant. As we move into high school, then we can start talking about the specifics of sexual reproduction, how this actually works. And that's where we'll talk about mitosis and meiosis. And so if we have these two birds right here, how do they sexually reproduce? Well, the mother is going to produce an egg, and the father is going to produce sperm, and they're going to transfer that sperm from the male to the female. What is really inside those egg and inside those sperm are chromosomes. And so in a typical human, for example, we'll have 46 chromosomes. What is that? It's our DNA. It's our genetic material. We only give half of our chromosomes to our offspring. And so I've really simplified it in this animation, but basically it's going to have chromosomes, and those chromosomes are sections of DNA. And on the DNA, we're going to have these different genes. And so when you create sperm or when you create egg, you're really only giving half of your DNA. So what happens when the sperm fertilizes the egg? We make a zygote. And that zygote is going to be a combination of the chromosomes from the mother and the chromosomes from the father. And you can see that the chromosomes will have different lengths, and we give them numbers. This would be chromosome 1, and this is 2. It's really oversimplified. Most organisms are going to have dozens and dozens of chromosomes, but we eventually have a fertilized egg. And so it's a union of the chromosomes from the male and the female. And so that will make an exact duplicate of itself, and that's called mitosis. And those two cells are now called daughter cells. And so mitosis is the process of going from that original cell to two copies of the cell, and then we make more of that cell, and then we make more of that cell. And so each of these are getting bigger, and then they're dividing, and so we call that growth. But if we were to let that keep going and going and going and going, what would you get? You would get a bird that just looks like that original cell, and we know that doesn't happen. And so each of these cells have to differentiate. What does that mean? They have to become different cells. Some of these cells are going to become nerve cells and muscle cells and bone cells. And the way they do that is through differentiation. So basically what that means is inside the chromosomes, they're going to turn on specific genes and turn off other genes. And so even as it's in this early stages, each of these cells are starting to become different cells or to differentiate. Now we're talking about development or change in that organism over time. Eventually, these become adults, and adults are going to still be made up of cells, but each of those cells are going to be different. So if we were to take these two cells, what happens, or two organisms, what happens next? Well, they give off their sperm and egg again to create the next generation. The creation of sperm and egg is called meiosis, and meiosis gives us variation. So each of the different sperm are going to be different. And you can see here that it's going to be a combination of chromosomes from the chromosomes that they got from their mother and from their father. And so there's a lot of variation within the creation of these sex cells, both egg and sperm. And eventually there's going to be union between the egg and the sperm, and that's going to create the next generation. So that's development, that's growth. Growth means gets bigger, development means gets different, and I hope that was helpful.